course, vertex algebras and arc spaces.
So, okay, thank you. So today I'm going to speak about Poisson vertex algebras, Lie filtration, and associated schemes. So in other words, I am going to define the objects that appeared in the right-hand side of the diagram, of the introduction last time. But before, I would like to rectify something I said last time. I say that this is a sheaf of differential algebras, but it is not exactly correct. I have to take the push forward of push forward the sheaf where pi infinity is a canonical projection. Actually, Raimondo already corrected me, but I misunderstood what he was saying last time. So the argument is what I wrote, but indeed I took open subset on X and not on the arc spaces. So sorry about that. All right, so I would like to start with Poisson vertex algebras, but maybe to motivate a little bit, let me recall that we intend to define the Lie filtration. So the Lie filtration will be a filtration on any vertex algebra, a decreasing filtration, and so that the corresponding graded space will be a commutative vertex algebra. And in such situation, it's quite natural to expect a richer structure. Indeed, if you know the classical setting, it is well known that there are interesting Poisson algebras coming from filtered non-commutative associated algebra. So this is a similar situation. So let me recall in the classical setting that if A is a filtered, let's say by some increasing filtration, associative non-commutative unital algebra such that the commutative graded algebra is the corresponding graded algebra is commutative, then this one inherits a natural Poisson structure. So let me recall quickly how it works. So filtered mean that AP AQ belongs to AP plus Q. And the fact that the corresponding graded algebra is commutative means that the bracket associators belong to actually, a priori they belong to AP plus Q, but in fact they belong to SP plus Q minus one if I take increasing filtration. And then you can define a Poisson bracket on Gr A with the canonical projection. Sorry. By declaring that this is the image of P plus Q minus one of A, B. Okay, with A B in AQ and B in AQ, AP and in AQ respectively. All right? So for example, a famous example are the following. So for example, on the enveloping algebra of any Lie algebra, you have the PBW filtration, and it is well known that the corresponding graded algebra is isomorphic to the symmetric algebra, which is the same as the coordinate ring over the dual. And here you recover the constant Kirilov-Surio-Poisson structures that come from the symplectic structure on coenjoint orbit. All right, so you recover a known Poisson structure. Another interesting example, if you have the algebra of differential operators on an algebraic group, let's say affine, then this is filtered by the degree of operators. And then it is also well known that the corresponding graded algebra is isomorphic to the coordinate ring over the cotangent space of, on G. And here you recover also the Poisson algebra structure coming from the symplectic structure on the cotangent space. All right, and the third example is the Zuse algebra of a vertex algebra. So we will see later. Sorry. Here I trace the commutator. Sorry. Thank you. So, yeah, I'm applying this property. Thank you. All right, so what I wanted to say, and in this setting, it will be the same. When we have this, we can expect a richer structure. And so I have to talk now about Poisson vertex algebras. So, I recall that commutative recalls that if a vertex algebra is commutative, then all endomorphism An are zero for n greater than zero. So in other words, this is zero for all positive n. All right? So the definition is the following. I start with V, a commutative vertex algebra. And then we say that V is a Poisson vertex algebra if there is a new bilinear product on V corresponding to new positive operators. So if they exist, a bilinear map. So from V to cross V to V lambda. So here I'm using the lambda bracket notation, but here I use Poisson notation. So to the tensor here, I associate a certain Poisson that I did not like this. I use the Poisson lambda bracket notation, and this is my notation for this. So it's similar to as in Jethro's talk, but here, okay, we have to be careful. There is now new operators, all right? Because remember that the old one for the commutative for the vertex algebra structure are all zero. So rigorously, I should use a new notation, but this is a bit too heavy. So I keep this confusing notation without any tilde for the sequel. But there is no ambiguity because I start with a commutative vertex algebra. So I want to define new product. And of course, this operation must satisfy a number of axioms such that are similar to the axiom of the Poisson algebra, of a Poisson algebra. But of course, here we have to take into account the translation operator, which is here, remember, a differential. So here I like to, maybe I'm right here. So here in my notation, partial is a differential on the commutative algebra. So such that, so we have, first of all, what we can call sesquilineality. So which says that this one should be minus lambda A lambda B. And we have also A lambda partial B, which has to be lambda plus partial A lambda B. Then we have a kind of skew symmetry. So this says that A lambda B is minus B minus lambda minus partial A. And then we have an analog of Jacobi identity, and then a left Leibniz rule. All right, so we have an analog of the Jacobi identity. So which says the following. Sorry. right? So this is really an analog. And last axiom is the left Leibniz rules, which says that A lambda B C. So remember that this is a product on V induced by the normally ordered product. So this is what you expect. You have this plus. And obviously, A, B, C belongs in V. All right. So in particular, you see that this last axiom implies that the endomorphism, the new one that I should denote for the first time with tilde, but I decided to forget about the notation, are derivations for the product, act as a derivation on the product on V. All right? So in other words, ANBC is ANBC plus A, B, sorry, plus B, A and C. All right. Yeah?
So by juxtaposition, the left Leibniz rule, that's the minus one product, or what is that? BC, for example, is just like B minus one C?
Sorry? Ah, this one, yeah, it is what I'm saying. Here, the product is a product that we defined on a commutative vertex algebra. This is B minus 1C. Yeah. Here now, I view, in these notations, I rather view as a differential algebra. So I use a product as usual product, and I prefer to use partial for the notation of the translation operators, but also here, it comes from the commutative vertex algebra structure. So again, here, don't confuse this new derivation with the previous one that is zero because we start with a commutative vertex algebra. Okay, so maybe as an exercise, you can, if you like, rewrite all axioms in terms of AM. And then you will see that you get something similar to Borchers identities for positive modes. So I don't do it because it's a bit long and not so useful, I think. I'm not going to prove many things. So exercise. So rewrite all axioms. So I did for the last one, for instance, in term of AN, BM, and etc. So in particular, you should obtain for Jacobi something like that. And then you can also wonder whether there is a right Leibniz rules. So this is a slightly less nice. So, but you can also rewrite as an exercise here, for instance, in Fourier modes. And then you have a right Leibniz rules, which can be written like that. So here you get this statement. And this is also useful in practice. Okay. All right, so let me now give some examples. And I explained last time, interesting geometric examples come from arc spaces. So I would like to, arc spaces over a Poisson scheme, of course. So I would like to explain example coming from that. So let me formulate a proposition that it is due to Tomoyuki Arakawa. So the theorem is the following. So given an affine Poisson scheme, so the spectrum of some Poisson algebra, there is a unique Poisson vertex algebra on the jet algebra of R such that, so in other words, such that what you want is that it extends the Poisson algebra on R. So you want, I can formulate in terms of lambda bracket, you want that this lambda bracket is recover the Poisson bracket on R for all AB in R. All right, so if you prefer, this means that A and B is a Kronecker symbol AB. Okay, so let me explain quickly the construction. You don't have so much choice to do that. And of course, and you can expect, we are going to use the fact that the jet algebra is generated as a differential algebra by R. And then you can see how it works, because if you look at the first axiom, if you can define the Poisson bracket on R here, that will be required by the hypothesis, then you see that you can extend as a first step. You differentiate and you have no choice. And then you can repeat using Leibniz rule, etc. So the construction is not so surprising. Maybe I erase, it's okay. You can remember. So I started to define lambda bracket over R, and then I don't have any choice for the extension. So proof. Oops. So first I define a bracket here, sending. So I did not with this notation, but this is just the usual Poisson bracket from we start with. And then this one satisfies, obviously. Obviously it satisfied. Everything except the first, so the skew symmetry, Jacobi. Sorry, this is P2. Jacobi and also Leibniz rule. All right? And then you can extend by, you extend uniquely. Sorry. Yeah, this makes sense. Okay. And then it extends uniquely. On the jet algebra. Okay, and then here, as I explained, this satisfies, which satisfies P1, P4, and I erase the skew symmetry, which is P2. And then you still have to work a little bit to show the Jacobi identity, but I let as an exercise. So then it remains to check Jacobi. P3, and then you can check as an exercise, it's not difficult. All right, so from this we can produce very interesting examples. I explained two examples of interesting Poisson algebras, and then now we can consider arcs of these examples. So, examples. So, let's consider the Poisson algebra that we discussed in the introduction. So, yeah. So, this is Poisson algebra. So, here G no need to be simple, it's any Lie algebra. Let's say algebraic Lie algebra. Maybe it's more interesting because the Poisson structure comes from the action here. So I recall quickly that how the Poisson bracket is defined. If you have element here, and then you take x in the dual, this is given by, so you can differentiate this function. So a priori, you get element in the dual of the dual, but then you can identify this canonically with G. And so it makes sense to consider the Poisson bracket. So then you have element in G, and then you can consider the pairing with X in the dual. So this is a canonical way to write this Poisson bracket. So now, So now, from the theorem, it says that the coordinate ring of the arc space of this is a Poisson algebra. The structure comes from this Poisson algebra structure. So let me comment a little bit how to understand this Poisson vertex algebra. So of course, yeah, coming from the Poisson algebra structure on it. So let me comment a little bit how to understand this. Because remember that last time, we have seen that if G acts on a variety, this induces an action at the level of arc spaces. So here, the group G acts on its Lie algebra and also on its dual. And so this induces an algebraic action on the arc space over this. All right? And then this is an algebraic group. It's a pro-algebraic group, but in any case, it's a group acting on this. And then you can differentiate the actions, and you can expect an action on the Lie algebra of this on this. And then you can wonder whether it's compatible with this. So this is what I want to explain. So in fact, by the Jacobi, maybe I should recall that here, just to fix notation, remember that this is just a polynomial algebra with infinite variables that I can write like this to fit notation of vertex algebra. Like this, where here, this is a basis of of G. All right? So this is my notation. So here you have only negative a priori endomorphism. And now I'm talking about the new one that comes from the Poisson vertex algebra. And so here, by the Jacobi identity, you get that xm, yn. So if you do the exercise, you will see that this is x0, y, m plus n. And this exactly corresponds to the Poisson bracket. But we are in the Lie algebra setting, so the Poisson bracket here is just the bracket, the Lie bracket. And here my notation is, of course, for x, y, in G and MN positive. All right? So, of course, I embed here inside the arc space when I write this. So, what does that mean? So, this implies that the Lie algebra of this, which is in fact the arc space of the Lie algebra G with obvious Lie bracket, act on this Poisson vertex algebra. So here, so maybe I explain how it acts by xt, xtn. I send just xn. All right. So here, the Poisson bracket, of course, it is what you think. So in other words, the Poisson vertex algebra structure comes from this action. So it's quite natural. So in other words, the Poisson vertex algebra structure on this comes from the action of this on the jet of the dual. All right. So I would like to consider another example. It's also a kind of characterization of the second example I gave about cotangent space of an algebraic group. So here, remember that we consider this affine algebraic group. So this is well known to be symplectic, and as such, the coordinate ring is a Poisson algebra. So this is a general statement, but in this setting, it's easy to understand the Poisson algebra structure. In fact, this cotangent space, you can write as a variety, as a product like this, all right? And so this is just a tensor product. And so how to understand the Poisson structure here? So you have natural Poisson embedding. Poisson algebra embedding. So here, this is, again, the Costan-Kirillov-Sourillo Poisson structure. And here, this is a trivial Poisson structure. Okay, so it remains to understand what is a Poisson between two elements, one in OG and here. And yeah, maybe I write here. You can read here. It's still okay? Yeah? So now, if F is in OG and X here, the Poisson, maybe I should write in this direction, the bracket here is given by the action of left invariant vector field on F. Well, act as a left invariant derivation. All right, so now here again you have a Poisson vertex algebra structure on the coordinate ring of arc space, and you have no choice for this Poisson vertex algebra if you want it's compatible with this one. So now, by the theorem, so you have, there exists a unique Poisson vertex algebra on the coordinate ring of jets of this that extends the Poisson algebra structure on this. And then here again, I don't give details, but again, it comes from properties of arcs. Remember that if we have a product, the jet of the product is the same as the product of jet. So this means that this coordinate ring is a tensor product of two Poisson vertex algebra. Okay, and so it's easy to describe the Poisson vertex algebra structure because we already have described this one. This one is trivial, and so between then, it's the same as before. So maybe I should just mention that we have, in terms of lambda bracket, maybe I can write, but the lambda bracket between element in J, so here, X, Y is in J, that I embed as before naturally in the jet here. You see here, as usual, I identify X minus 1 with element in G. And this is embedded into, I should first say this, and then this is here. Yeah, this is my explanation that X is identified with X minus 1, and you have this. So this is for this part, so we have already described. Here it's trivial. So if F and G are in OG, that I embed also here, this is trivial. And similarly as before, the lambda bracket between X and F is given by the action of the left invariant vector field. Okay, and this uniquely extends, so it's well defined. Yeah.
So I suppose this would be this is the classical limit of K1, or maybe called the
I don't know what Tomoyuki called. Ah, yeah, yeah, this is my next question, exactly. So now the next question, we define Poisson vertex algebra. A natural question is, are there interesting vertex algebras, so I mean by that non-commutative, that quantize this? So this is exactly what I want to do. But to make sense of quantize, I need to introduce Lie filtration. So I talk... Ah, that's a good question. You are talking about the CDO. Yeah. And then you want to know whether it's compatible with this Poisson vertex. Yeah, you can, of course, make everything with a right vector field. Is it your question? And then it coincides with this, if I am correct. Yeah. Yeah, of course, that's a good point. Here, I made a choice by acting by the left invariant vector field. Yeah, the commute, yeah. So as Alberto mentioned, there were two questions in his question, but first natural question is now we want to quantize these examples. So question, are there interesting non-commutative vertex algebra that quantize these examples. So I mean by that, in my diagram, can I find vertex algebra on the left top corner? So to make sense of this, I want to talk about Lie filtration. So you probably have already seen the definition during Tomoyuki's lecture. So please stop me if it is too much repetition. At least I would like to give again the definition. Okay, so I start with V, so this time an arbitrary vertex algebra. So I mean by that, of course, not necessarily not commutative, otherwise not so interesting. And with generating field, collection of fields, sorry. Like this. So I fix generating collection of fields. And so here, a priori, I is arbitrary, but in most of cases, you can choose I to be finite. In most cases, one can assume I finite. For example, in the case of the affine vertex algebra, you can choose generating field. So maybe I write like that. You can find a collection with A running through J. Mm-hmm. And for Virasoro also, you have one generating field. So in most of cases, we can assume this. All right, and the Lie filtration is defined as follows. So it's due to Haisheng Lie. Okay, I'm not sure. E after that? Maybe. Okay, so set for any positive P so I take the vector space generated by element of this form. Where the I, j runs through I, and n1 plus, etc., and r is greater than p. Okay, so this is the definition of the Lie filtration. So obviously, from the definition, this is a decreasing filtration, and v coincides with v0. All right. And then is decreasing. And also what is clear, quite clear from the definition is that if you, translation operators move the leaf filtration. So it sends Fp. So this belongs to Fp plus 1. Okay? So this definition is useful in practice to understand what it is. But one thing you can wonder is whether it's really canonical, because a priori it depends on the choice of the generating field. So in fact, it's not the case. So it's really canonical. And then we have a lemma, which makes sure this is canonically defined. So, lemma. So, in fact, this can be defined by induction. I'm not sure I start. Yeah, maybe this is correct. Okay, so you have this formula. Yeah, this is correct. Yeah. And so this is my notation for what you can imagine. It's a vector space generated by element like this, where A is here and B is here. So in this way, you see that FPV does not depend on the generating field. So the proof of this lemma is a bit technical, so I omit. Sorry? Fj? This is Fp?
Yes, and the second F is J.
If P minus J. J?
F?
Zero. Is this V, in fact? Just V. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I wrote like this because to make sure that this is indeed in Fp. But yeah, it's just V. So the proof is a bit technical. So you argue on the length, by induction on the length of element, and use Borchet's identity. But I don't give induction. So in particular, the leaf filtration does not depend on All right. So next step, we would like to show that the corresponding graded space is a commutative vertex algebra. So let's consider this space now. So, and then this, first we want to show that this is a commutative vertex algebra. So first we, of course, need to show that it is a vertex algebra, and then see why it's commutative. But the vertex algebra structure, as you can imagine, it's come from the vertex algebra structure. So the definition is quite natural. So let's denote, as usual, the canonical projection. So you can expect that the product of two elements. So I remind you that commutative vertex algebra, I'm going to define the differential algebra. So I need to define the product and the differential. But the product, what could be a reasonable product? We can expect it come from the normally ordered product. So we can expect it is something like that. All right, this is quite natural. So for this, we need to understand how this general product Fp with Fq here, and more generally like this, we want to understand where it goes. This is what we need. And second, for the differential, we have not so much choice. It's quite natural to expect this. We have already seen that the translation operator move Fp to Fp1. So this, quite natural to expect it will be this. All right? So this is what we want to make sense. So here we have a more general statement about how Fp minus j minus 1 Fq goes, where it goes. So here again, it's a bit technical lemma, so I'm not going to prove, but at least I want to explain the statement. So the statement is the following. First of all, with similar notation as before, I write like this. This goes to Fp plus q minus 1 minus n minus 1 v. And this holds for any pq. So I put in z for some reason, but my convention is that Fp, I put this because here I want to make sense even if it is strictly negative, but this is by convention zero if p is negative. Yes, and then n is a priori any integer. So this makes sure that this makes sense, first of all. And second, for positive n, we have a stronger statement that fpv n fqv belongs to fp plus q minus nv. Okay, so this is stronger. For positive n, it's enough to prove this statement. Okay, and this will make sure that this is with the vertex algebra structure, it will be commutative. Okay, so I don't prove the statement, but as you can imagine, this is the hardest part. This is slightly easier for negative n. This is roughly the same idea as here, and here it's a bit harder. So again, it's technical, so I don't prove the statement. But now I want to explain the vertex algebra structure. Okay, so proposition. So GrFv is a commutative vertex algebra by what I said. So sorry, Fp zero?
When p is negative, shouldn't you
put it equal to v? Ah, yeah, sorry, yeah, thank you. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just repeating what I wrote before, but now it's a statement. A. So of course A is in FPV and B in FQV. Okay, so here maybe I give some details. So there are two things to check. First of all, we want to have a vertex algebra structure and then check its commutative. So for the vertex algebra structure, it comes from the vertex algebra structure on V. So first of all, this is a vertex algebra. So maybe I wrote differently. Inherit that come from the vertex algebra structure on V. So in other words, I defined field of element in the graded space like this. So because of this statement here, I take sigma p plus q minus n minus 1 of A. So maybe I apply to some element, okay? Okay, so this makes sense. And for the translation, for the vacuum, of course, I take the image of the vacuum. And for the translation, we also have not so much choice. So the vacuum is just sigma zero of the vacuum of V. And for the translation operators, I send this one to sigma p a minus 2 applied to the vacuum. And this is, in fact, what you expect. All right. So first exercise, check the vertex algebra axioms. Check the vertex algebra axioms. And now it follows from the second part of the lemma that this is a commutative because of the equivalence properties that we have seen last time. So second, by the lemma, this is automatically commutative. All right. So now, as I mentioned, because it's commutative, we can expect a richer structure of Poisson vertex algebra. And this is the next step we do. But here, it's very similar to the classical setting for the Poisson vertex algebra structure. It's natural to define new positive operator just by taking, here you don't take minus one. Okay, you just do that. Okay? So next step, proposition. This is actually is a Poisson vertex algebra by, so here I define the notation by endomorphism. So I define the product, the new product for positive n by taking sigma p plus q minus n. So a n b. Okay, so in terms of lambda bracket, it just gives you all right, any questions? So we are going to see example, but it's like in the classical setting, it may happen that this Poisson vertex algebra's algebra structure is trivial. But if you start with a non-commutative vertex algebra, you can always go one step further and then get a non-trivial Poisson algebra, vertex algebra structure, similar to the classical setting. So we will see some interesting example with Virasoro. But now I would like to mention the ZOO-C2 algebras and the connection with this before I give examples. So, okay, so now define RV to be, in fact, the first graded space of this graded algebra. So that is to say V over F1V. And from the lemma, the first lemma, in fact, F1V, you see that it's nothing but the vector space generated by such element. And this is usually denoted also C2V by a historical reason, I think. So this is just a quotient a priori, but this quotient has a Poisson algebra structure that comes from the Poisson vertex algebra structure. And also, it generates Grevy as differential algebra. So exercise show that RV is a Poisson algebra by, so if you think of the Poisson vertex algebra structure, you can guess what is the product, because this is just a normally ordered product. So this is my notation for the, I used before sigma zero, but here you can just take the image. I did not like this. And then the Poisson bracket is given by the previous Poisson bracket with sigma zero, so in other words, is given by a zero b, and the unit is the image of vacuum. All right, and this is this Poisson algebra that we call the ZOO-C2 algebra. Okay, so definition. The Poisson algebra RV is called the ZOO-C2 algebra. So, and now it makes sense to consider the corresponding scheme. So this is what we call the associated scheme. And sometimes it's also enough to consider the corresponding radius scheme. And this is the associated variety. All right, so I just mentioned without proof that V is generated as differential algebra by RV. It's not so easy, so theorem as a differential algebra, V is generated by RV. So similarly, you remember that the jet algebra is generated by R. The jet algebra over a Poisson algebra R is generated as a differential algebra by R. All right, so as a consequence, I just mentioned one consequence of this for the moment. We will see others later. But in particular, assume that the filtration is separated, so that this is zero. So in particular, as a vector space, these two are isomorphic. And then assume also that I is finite and that your generating collection of fields is finite. Then this implies that RV is finitely generated. Then the image here generates RV. So, I'm sorry, this has nothing to do with that. It's rather if I want to make converse. If this generates this, because it generates this as differential algebras, we can also, what I want to say? Okay, maybe I don't want to say. Maybe I just say by voice, and so I remove in particular. So, okay, this is interesting because now I'm going to assume this so that RV is always finitely generated, and so in particular, my scheme here will be of finite type. So from now on, I assume this. So I assume I finite and also the filtration is good, is separated. But what I wanted to say is that the converse is also true. If RV is finitely generated, then V is finitely strongly generated. So this means I can choose a finite collection of generating field. So it's badly written on the blackboard, but you understand what I mean. So, okay, by the theorem, since RV. All right, so now I would like to give some examples. Any question for these theoretical statements? Okay, so for Vira Zoro, I just make as an exercise. So the first example, I consider the Vira Zoro vertex algebra, so I'm using notation of Naoki Stokes last week. Okay, so this is a Lie Vira Zoro algebra. I don't rewrite the bracket, but we have already seen this, and I just recall the OPE. So as an exercise, so this is easy from the definition. First of all, you can show that the leaf filtration gives the corresponding leaf. So this is V in my notation. Or maybe I don't. I rewrite. So this is isomorphic to the polynomial algebra generated by L minus 2, L minus 3, etc. Second, you can deduce from this that the ZOO C2 algebra is just the polynomial algebra in one variable, where x is the image of L minus 2, where x is the image of L minus 2 applied to the vacuum in the ZOO C2 algebra. So all this is not difficult. And next, if you consider the Poisson vertex algebra structure here, you will find the trivial one. But still, we can define by going next step, one more step, a non-trivial Poisson vertex algebra. So third, show that one can undo F vir with a non-trivial Poisson vertex algebra structure such that the lambda bracket become TL plus 2 lambda L. Okay? Okay, so this is for Vira Zoro. And so now I would like to consider the case of the affine vertex algebra. So I keep Jesro's notation. So here G is simple. And it follows from the description I gave before. So remember that F1V can be described also as follows. So it's almost, yes, something like that. So here, this is V. So you can describe like this and B and I. Okay, and then, yeah, that's all. Mm-hmm. So maybe I don't need I here. Okay. All right, so you can describe like this, and then it follows from this description that this first pieces is in fact T minus 2. It's just this. Mm-hmm. Sorry? Ah, yeah, one, yeah. Sorry, thank you. So here, remember that as a vector space, this is isomorphic to the enveloping algebra of this. Maybe I recall that. Okay, so as vector space. Right, so then in this case, it's easy to understand the ZOO C2 algebra. So I think Tomoyuki already explained this, so maybe I don't give so much details. So here, by the PBW theorem, we get an isomorphism of Poisson algebra from this Poisson algebra to the ZOO C2 algebra of this one, which is just this, so sending homogeneous element like this to the image in the quotient. And this is an isomorphism of Poisson algebra. Right. So in other words, in this case, so this is just the previous example of Poisson algebra that we already studied. And so in particular, here, as a scheme, this is the dual of the Lie algebra with the usual Poisson bracket. And maybe in the following, I would like to identify with G through the ceiling form so that I view scheme and associated variety in G. It's okay? And here this is the same as the associated variety, of course, it's already reduced. All right, so for the moment, I concentrate on this case, but you see that in this case, what we get here does not depend anymore on the level. So to have more interesting example, we need to take quotient. So I will go back to this, but let me just mention what's happened for the quotient. So now, if I consider the unique graded simple quotient, so here, a priori, but it's not a priori, it's exactly this. This is, in fact, a quotient of this one. If now V is a quotient here, this map is not anymore an isomorphism, it's just surjective, and this is a quotient. But here, this ideal depends on K in general. And concretely, as a variety, you can think of this as the zero locus of the kernel of the map sending, of this surjective map. All right, so we go back later on a more detailed example. To finish with example, I would like to consider now what's happened for the Lie filtration, because here I directly discussed on the zoo situ algebra, but what is the corresponding graded space? So what about Gr-F VKG? So if you remember the diagram, so I am here, and we have seen that here I get this one. So now we have seen that there is a nice Poisson vertex algebras, Poisson vertex algebras given by the arc space of this. So what is the connection between these two objects? So in this case, they are actually the same. So let me explain a little bit. So I recall that this is, I already mentioned, but I can write, it's a polynomial algebra with infinitely many variables like this. And so, in fact, this is isomorphic to the symmetric algebra of this one. Just sending an element here to x, t minus 1. This is a bit strange. Sorry, like this. Yep. All right, so you have a canonical isomorphism of algebra between this and this. And now, remember that we have this. And if you consider the PBW filtration, the corresponding graded space is isomorphic to that. So if I consider the PBW filtration of this, this is also this. But the PBW filtration is increasing while the Lie filtration is decreasing. So a priori, we cannot really compare directly the same. But we will see that as commutative vertex algebras, they are actually the same. So let me explain why it is true. So in fact, there is a general statement that we have a surjection PV, Poisson vertex algebra surjective morphism from the arc space of the zoo C2 algebra to the corresponding graph of the vertex algebra. So see, I will state a more general statement for this, but in this situation, it gives this surjective Poisson vertex algebra morphism. And moreover, so now I want to say that this is actually an isomorphism. So both are graded. And in fact, here I don't want to use this grading, but here, this one is graded by just stating that the degree of ST minus 1 is just applied to a vacuum, is just 1. All right? And this one is also naturally graded by the same grading, actually, identifying with this. Okay, so, and also this one, with the same definition, actually. The notation are compatible. So now, because in this case, the leaf filtration is separated, this is isomorphic to this as a vector space, and the corresponding graded component are the same. So this is actually an isomorphism. As vector space, and now here, the graded component has the same dimension. All right, so the conclusion that it is in this case, we have in fact an isomorphism. So here I can, maybe I rewrite the diagram. So here the diagram is as follows. So here we get, in fact, a priori maybe what we get more naturally is this one. And this is precisely the arc of the zoo C2 algebra. Okay, and to complete the diagram, I should mention what is the zoo algebra here. So in fact, the zoo algebra here is the enveloping algebra of G. We haven't mentioned that, but the correspondence is given by, So you send X for X in G to the image of XT minus 1 in the zoo algebra. All right, so I don't discuss so much about this part, but here you notice that this is filtered by the PBW filtration, and here if I take the corresponding graded Poisson algebra, I recover this one. So here, the picture is very nice. Everything commutes. But as you can see, nothing depends on the level here. So to get more interesting diagram, we need to take quotients. This is what we will do probably next time. Okay, I would like to finish, not to finish, but this part about the next example. So what Alberto wanted to discuss, yeah? Yeah.
What if you take simple quotient?
Simple, not graded. This I don't know so much. What you want to say is that if I take a quotient of this, still a vertex algebra, but it is not graded. Yes, that's true.
Is it important
for simple graded quotient? No, but you take a quotient which is, you take a quotient that it gives a vertex algebra structure. I don't know. Yeah, okay, so next, sorry, I don't know so much. Yeah. So next example is precisely the algebra of chiral differential operators that must chiral quantize the cotangent space. So I don't give so much details, I just give the idea. So vertex algebras, chiral vertex algebras of chiral differential operators on G, as before. So let's define for a complex key this G hat module a priori. So here I tensorize again above this subalgebra, and here I take the coordinate ring of the jet of the group. So I need to explain how this acts on this. So here, so K acts as K identity, as before, on and here GT that you can embed into the Lie algebra of this act as left invariant vector field. All right, so I think this was introduced independently by, Malikov, Chetman, and Ventrob. Belinson, Drinfeld, and Arkhipov, Gatesbury. So Malikov, Ventrob, and Schechtman did in a more general setting, but here I took, with X is smooth here, but here I took the case of group because it's easier. And then there is a vertex algebra structure on it. So I just give the statement. Okay, so there is a unique vertex algebra structure on these modules, such that with the following OPE. So, in fact, it's enough to describe. So, first of all, for the affine Lie algebra part. Sorry, this is lambda bracket. Okay, so for F in OG, I first describe here. So here it's a trivial also lambda bracket that I embed into this. And then here again, if X is in G and F in OG, it is again the action by left invariant vector field. All right, so now a nice exercise. So as an exercise, you can show that exactly arguing as before, that the corresponding graded Lie filtration correspond to the, maybe I explain a little bit. So, as an exercise, using the previous example, shows that the Lie filtration of this one gives tangent space of this one. All right, so Yeah, so to see this, remember that this is a tensor product of algebra, and then use the previous example. So we have discussed already the two examples, so you just combine what we did before. So here also I would like to draw the picture. Yeah, I'm running to be a bit late, but okay. So here again, everything works smoothly because this is, I haven't mentioned, but here, the ZOO C2 algebra, you recover the coordinate ring of the cotangent space here. This also you can do as an exercise using the previous example. And so here, everything, this coincides with the arcs of this one. And here, what is the ZOO algebra? You can guess what it is, because this one we discussed at the beginning of the talk, it is a natural quantization, which is the algebra of differential operators on G. So here again, everything commutes nicely. Okay, but... Okay, so this here I put on dot line because this is not really topic of this lecture. But ZOO's algebra was defined in Jethro's talk, lectures, the last one. So this is, for general V, it's a certain quotient of V. And I think you defined at least the product, no? More or less, okay. So here, similarly to this, this quotient is just a quotient, and then it defines the product on this, which is associative, non-commutative in general. And what Jethro explained, and this I'm going to use in my next lecture, is that you have a correspondence between irreducible graded module here and a simple module here. So it's very nice for representation theory. And what I will discuss next time is that there is also a deep connection between these two objects that makes that we can use sometimes the shape or the geometry here to understand the ZOO algebra and so modules here. For the moment, today I just introduce objects and examples, but interesting application will be done next lecture. I'm sorry I didn't have time today, but... I'm just explaining. Is it okay? So maybe next time I can refresh a little bit for applications. Yeah, okay. So maybe one thing I forgot is to explain this surjective map from arc space, coordinate ring of arc space and Grev in general. Yeah? No, this dot is just to say that I'm not going to define properly. But what I want to say is this one is naturally filtered by the degree of operators. And here again, everything commutes smoothly. So this means by doing this, I recover the ZOO C2 algebra, which is in general not true, but still I am saying that there is deep connection. All right, so yeah, I forgot to mention the general fact about connection between this Grev and the arcs of the ZOO algebra, because in the two examples, it turns out that it is actually the same, but in general, we have the following proposition due to Tomoyuki. Maybe also I should cite Lee, because, okay, I'm stating. So there is a Poisson vertex. Okay, so I will comment. So there is a Poisson vertex algebra surjective morphism from the jet algebra of RV to GrevV. So in particular, you see that the spectrum of this one, which usually is denoted by this, it's a singular support, is contained in the arc space of the scheme, associated scheme. All right? In general, we have this. I will go back next time to this two interesting scheme. So for the proof, In fact, here we haven't still used the universal properties of jet algebra, but here it's very important because you see that you have. I need a bit more space. So you remember that I defined the jet algebras by the universal properties amongst differential algebras, and this is very useful in this kind of statement. So it's due to Lee, okay. Okay. So you have a natural map just given by identity, so sending A to A in FV. And on the other hand, you remember that you have the embedding that we defined in the first lecture here. And by the universal property, there exists a map here as differential algebra morphism. And now it's clearly surjective because RV generates GRE-FV as differential algebra. I haven't proved this, but here you can use this for that. And now it remains to check it's a Poisson vertex algebra. And this I don't do it. So this is a nice exercise, but it's enough to check that we have this. Essentially for generators. All right. Okay, so this is all what I wanted to say about examples. So in the remaining times, I would like to start discussing the Lee condition, the least condition. What is clear? Yes, because in fact, both are generated by RV as differential algebras. So if you have this comes from all here, so you have clearly someone here above. Yeah, so far we have introduced objects, but why they are interesting, this is not clear for the moment. So I would like to discuss a little bit the least condition. So I remind you that the idea of all these objects, in particular associated schemes, is that the geometry of this one, and sometimes even this one is enough, reflect important properties of the vertex algebra V. Okay? So in the previous example, as you can see, we lose many things. We don't have central charge appearing, we don't have level, and so on. So as I said, it will be more interesting to consider simple quotients. And then in this idea, it's naturally to start with the easiest example, where this one has a dimension zero, which is not the case in previous examples. But in this setting, the easiest case. What does that mean? That this has dimension zero. So definition. V is called V least if the dimension of the associated scheme, or so I don't need to take scheme as a variety, is zero. All right. So remember that I have assumed that RV is finitely generated. So this is equivalent to say that RV is finite dimensional. So in this sense, least vertex algebras are generalization of finite dimensional algebras. And we will see in some examples that it's really the case. So Yeah, maybe I have time to state why this condition, some properties that illustrate that this geometric condition give very nice properties on such vertex algebras. So unfortunately, today there will no example, so none of the previous examples, Alice. But we will see next time. Okay, so why is there an least? So nice properties of least vertex algebras. So first of all, if V is conformal, so I remind you that this means that you have an action of Virasoro. Okay, so in particular L0 acts, and then I assume that V is also positively graded for the action of L0. And then I also assume V0 to be trivial. So this is what we usually call conical. All right? And also least. So together with conical assumption, being of dimension 0, if V is conical, just means that the associated variety is just a point. Because in fact, these conical properties imply that the associated scheme is indeed conical. You have a contracting C star action. All right, so assuming this, then any simple V module is automatically L0 graded. And so this is not easy at all. I'm just stating nice properties without any proof. And moreover, it is automatically Z graded. So this is not, second part is not difficult once we have this. So moreover, it is then Z graded. And also, I don't know how, I will explain what I mean by positively graded. So what I mean, any simple module, let's say V, has this shape. So it is what Jethro called positive energy representation. So this means here I summate over positive integer, but I might start with some lambda in C. And then my assumption here is that this is not zero. And this is what Jethro called low level. And this is what we call top level in our book, but that's not important. Okay, so this is what we obtained. And moreover, and still, so the key point is this, and after this is not difficult, and each component is finite dimensional. So all this is very nice because, I have no time to develop too much, but as I say, we have a deep connection with the Zuse algebra, and this implies that there are finitely many simple V modules. Maybe I have time to quickly recall this. So second, general fact. So as I mentioned, there is a deep connection between the Zuse C2 algebra and the Zuse algebra. So this one is filtered. I remember that for Zuse algebra, I start with a graded vertex algebra, and the filtration on ZuV come from the graded structure. And so this is a very easy filtered algebra. And this is a Poisson algebra surjective morphism. And so, in particular, if V is this, then in particular the dimension of the Zuse algebra is also finite. This one is also finite dimensional. This one is, but this one also. And by the Zuse correspondence, the number of simple V modules is automatically finite. So this is very nice because every simple V module, first of all, is automatically graded, positively graded, and it is with this condition, this is what Naoki called ordinary representation, so irreducible ordinary representation, and moreover, there are finitely many of them. So I should stop. This is nice because then we can define normalized characters, and this has also nice property. So just to conclude, you see that this very easy condition to state implies many things about V. So next time I give more examples and also consider larger family of examples and give applications. Yeah, I should stop. F is affine, but you need a Poisson structure on X. Yeah. If X is just Poisson scheme, so you mean not affine. So then you consider sheaf, and as a sheaf, it's still a Poisson vertex Poisson algebra. Again, you need push forward. Yeah. Again. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I should mention names, but okay. I will summarize next time. Actually, so this is a deep theory. It's not easy to prove. And I'm not sure. Abbé Bouledong, maybe. Abbé Bouledong. For this part is essentially Zhou, because I'm using a Zhou. And then the properties about normalized characters is maybe I should also mention Miyamoto. Mm-hmm. So I will summarize next time all what I'm saying. Yeah. So this is theorem, and this is easier, this part.